Well, hi, this is Jay Arthur, author of Lean Six Sigma Demystified and the QI Macros. We received a query from a customer this week, and they were saying, well, you know, how do I adjust my spec limits so that I get the answer I want and my, you know, my CP and CPK will look better? Well, spec limits are like goalposts, right, in football. And the trick is those are set by customers. Not by you. All right. Now, if you run the QI macros and take the defaults, they'll use three standard deviations, and that'll give you a CPK of one, CP and CPK of one. Now, if you expand that tolerance by a third, or 1/6 on either side, that'll get you to about 1.33 CP and CPK. Expand it by 2/3, that'll get you to about 1.66 CP and CPK. And if you go to 2 times the tolerance, oh my gosh, you'd be 6 sigma. But what's wrong with this picture? Your customer sets your spec limits. And when your customer sets your spec limits, then you have to figure out how to collapse the variation within there so you can get to 2 sigma within their limits, not the limits that you want to invent. So I think people try to find ways to tweak the numbers to get the answer they want rather than moving their process so that they get the answer they want. So start improving your process and stop trying to fool around with the numbers. I'm Jay Arthur. That's my improvement insight for this week.